This is TWiT.
This comes from our Kita by the name of David Bruns. And Jason, what does he say? He
says, what is the best way to protect yourself at college on a college network? I'm going to have a NAS, network attached storage set up there too. And what is the best way to protect as much as possible? Unfortunately, my college does not allow routers, so that is out.
Right, so we spoke about this briefly last week. Essentially what I told him was, in order to protect yourself, the obvious part is visible. You have to get the thing out of eyesight, because if they come into your dorm room and they see you have a router connected, the jig is up.
That's like a standard in dorm rooms now, that you can't have a router in your...
Really, this was unique in the fact that he said they actually go into rooms to check. I've never heard of that before. In fact, at our universities, we would never do that, because that would be a gross violation of privacy. But that's what happens at his place. I have to assume that's their policy.
Interesting.
However, the main way that they're going to detect is electronically. What kind of information can they get from the device when it's connected to the network? And we told him that there were a couple of strategies, a few things that he could try to make it more difficult for them to figure out that he actually has a router. And of course, the reason why he wants the router is because he wants to protect himself. You have to assume that something like a college network is entirely hostile, because I guarantee you there's at least one student who's learning a little bit about network security, or maybe he already knows, who is hammering away at the different devices that are connected, just looking what's out there. Well, you don't want to risk that. So you want to have something between your devices and the other devices on the network. And the best way to do that is with a consumer router, something that can do NAT and firewall. And in our case, I've chosen this. This is the Synology RT2600. This is their newest release. This is actually my backup unit. I have an RT2600 that's currently powering my network at home. This is way overkill for what we're going to do, but it is my favorite, so I brought it out. Do you want to see really quickly a few of the things that you could do?
I want to see that.
Okay. And by the way, the tools we're going to be showing you, totally free. You can download this. Okay. And I expect you to do this.
I will. Definitely download all of these free tools.
Okay, so what we need to do first is we need to make sure that we've turned off anything that might identify the router very easily. And unfortunately for you, I'm sorry, I know this is a pain, you're going to have to turn off your wireless. Wireless it's literally a beacon. If your IT guy goes around your dorm room with just a mobile device and a Wi-Fi scanner, they can very quickly figure out which rooms have Wi-Fi access points. And since they're not their Wi-Fi access points, they can assume that you also have it attached to a router. So, no wireless. Bummer, but it's absolutely necessary. So, if you go to HDMI 1 or 2, this one. On the Synology, it's super, super simple. So, all I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the Network Center, I'm going to go into Wireless, and there's a little button here for turning on and off Wi-Fi, and I just have to turn it off, unfortunately. I just do this. I know it's a bummer, especially since it's so convenient to have wireless. But Jason, the problem is, even if I hide this, even if I make it so that it's not advertising itself, anyone outside with even the smallest bit of networking knowledge knows how to look for them. And if they see it, it's basically a searchlight saying, look in this room.
I mean, even if you just have an app, like I know you've shown off on the network many times, just a simple app that you can have on your phone that's constantly scanning for these things.
Precisely.
And they can pick up the power of that bit based on where they're at. And if it's coming through screaming while you're in the room, then you know it's there. Right?
And unfortunately, some people see there's that setting for hidden SSID, which basically means that it doesn't display itself. So it doesn't come up in your list of available Wi-Fi access.
But it's still a frequency that's out there.
It's still a frequency, So if someone has a tool that's just looking for energy being emitted, they're going to see your device, and then they could just DF, direction find it. So you have a directional antenna, and on your device, you just turn it back and forth until it gets the strongest as possible, and you head off in that direction.
Dang.
Yeah. Again, sorry, but wires are your friend. So that's the easy part. Congratulations, you've just made it possible for a super low-level entry to not be able to find the fact that you've got something in your room. However, the problem is you're still connected to the campus network, which means you need to do what you can to make sure that this doesn't look like a router to your campus network. So we're going to use a tool called Nmap.
Is it like a camouflage tool? Like,
well, no. This is
what does it make it appear to be?
Well, the Nmap is just a security tool. So all it's going to do is it's going to allow me to scan a range or scan a particular IP address, and it will tell me what it can see on that IP address.
Oh, okay.
So the way that a network works.
Oh, so it's like a window into what others could see about
precisely.
You. Precisely. Because you right. want to know that, of course.
Yeah, I want to be able to see what they can see. And Nmap is one of these tools that it's so basic and it shows me so much that it gives me a window into that person's mind.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, if you want to find out exactly how this works, you're going to want to go to our Networking 101 series where we did an entire episode on ports and Nmap. But let me give you the skivvy, Jason. When I think of a device on my network, I'm typically only thinking of the IP address, like 192.168.1.10,
mm-hmm.
right? So that's my IP address. But within that IP address, I have multiple ports. Now, ports are what they sound like. They're ports where you can have services listening, ready to respond to a request.
Right, okay? Right.
So for example, FTP or HTTP, which is www. Or HTTPS. They all have a particular port associated with that service. So it would actually be 192.168.1.10. And then colon 21, port 21 for FTP, mm-hmm. or 80 for HTTP, or 443 for HTTPS. I don't have to type that in because the browser understands that when I type in HTTP or HTTPS to append that. But in the network side, I can see those ports open. If I have a web server, I definitely have port 80 open. If I have an FTP server, I definitely have port 21 open. If any of those are visible from the outside world by the IT manager, they know you're running something on your network.
Mm.
Right. So let me show you what it looks like. If you go to my other computer here, Alex, this is just running Nmap. This was a quick test I did. But there's some computer on this network here in the studio that has all of its ports open. This is really bad. I'm going to track that down after the show. I don't know what that
is. Please don't track it to me.
Oh,
please
my
don't
gosh.
Track it
Look
to me.
Look at that. Seriously. It's like all the ports. All the ports. I can skip to that. So I've got
101 IP addresses.
I know that my this is actually on the outside of my network. So this is on the WAN side of my router. I know my router is 10.135.25.202. So I'm going to put Nmap 10.135.25.202. What's this? What this is doing now is it's looking at that IP address, and it's collecting all the data it possibly can. What ports are open, and what will it report back? Now, take a look at this. So this is a tool that an administrator at the college or university that I'm sitting at could easily run from his desktop. This has come back, and it's told me already that port 1723, although I've closed it, is available. That's the VPN port. So it means I most likely have a VPN application running on the Synology, which makes it visible. I'm going to have to shut that down. Something else, and we'll talk about this one a little bit later, is look at it finds the MAC address. So that's the media access control, the physical address of the adapter within the router that's connected to the network. This knows the physical address 00113268 4368, and it knows because of the prefix 001132 that it's a Synology device.
Oh, so that's unique to Synology?
That's unique to Synology. Okay. So manufacturers are giving out chunks of these addresses that they can use for their devices. So just from that information that it returned, that very simple information, an IT manager will say, okay, it's Synology, so it's either a NAS or a router. Both of those I don't want on my network.
Mm-hmm.
And it's running a VPN, which means, again, it's a NAS or a router. Both of those are dead giveaways, and it would very quickly lead to a trip to your room from the IT guy who's looking for the device that shouldn't be there.
And they don't have to be in the vicinity to check this out. They just have to be connected to the network
their
end, wherever they happen to be.
Precisely. And if they're good network administrators, they don't ever even have to leave the data center. Mm-hmm. They can just sit there and port scan their network all day and just look for these rogue devices that start popping up.
Okay.
But thankfully, Jason, there's a couple of things we can do to make their job a little harder.
Of course there is.
Yeah. So the first thing we're going to want to do is we need to turn off the VPN services. And not just turn them off, but we also have to make it so that they're not visible, completely invisible. So
Now, does that mean that you cannot do VPN?
Correct.
At all?
At all.
Okay.
Yeah. Because the second you open up that port, if they're running a port scan, they're going to see
they're
a service
know right
available.
Away. And they probably have the ability with their software to instantly recognize when something appears on the network out of nowhere and give that red flag and say, hey, something new popped up.
Precisely. So on my network, I actually wouldn't be running Nmap. It's my switch. My switch just tells me, oh, I've never seen traffic on this port before.
Right.
You want to take a look at this. It would actually flag it for me and I could take it, check it out later. Any IT administrator worth his salt is going to be doing the same thing. Because that's how we run torrents. We use weird ports. And when you start seeing weird ports that haven't been used before, it typically means someone's trying to get around the security that I've created.
Got it.
Yeah. So unfortunately, a lot of this is you're not going to be able to do the things that you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
But at least you can get a router.